Off the east coast of Australia, there's a narrow, rocky spike called Ball's Pyramid. It's taller than Taipei 101, but only a few hundred meters wide, and it looks like something on an alien planet. It's what's left of an ancient volcano worn down over millions of years. But this video isn't just about weird geology. It's about how a group of climbers made it to the top of this remote island and accidentally found an insect thought to be extinct, barely surviving in a single bush. What happened in the years to follow kicked off a worldwide effort to bring back the species from extinction. Let's zoom out a bit here and learn a little bit of background about this place. Ball's Pyramid is around 24 kilometers away from Lord Howe Island up here. Zooming out even further, this place is almost 800 kilometers away from Sydney, Australia. These islands were sighted in 1788 by Henry Lidgbird Ball, who this island was actually named after. Now, Ball's Pyramid was mostly ignored for a long time, and then in 1853, it was finally surveyed. The first known landing was in 1882 by Henry Wilkinson. Where our story gets really interesting is the 1960s. People in the climbing community wanted to get to the top of this thing as no one had climbed it before. However, this would not be an easy hike. It's a sheer rocky cliff with high winds, lots of sharks surrounding the island, and no landing spot for a boat. The first serious climbing effort was in 1964, led by Dick Smith and a bunch of others in Scouts Australia. It turned out to be a very difficult climb, and day by day, their food and water sources ran dry, and 5 days in, they ended the effort. However, this effort was not a complete failure. They saw something that hadn't been seen in 44 years. They saw a dead Dryococelus australis, or Lord Howe Island Fasmid, or locally, tree lobster. But wait, this insect went extinct in 1920, I thought. Well, let's look into this. These phasmids were found all over Lord Howe Island, and sometimes used as fish bait. Lord Howe Island was a kind of utopia for these phasmids. Not a lot of predators, plenty of food, and they were honestly thriving. That is, until the rats came. Yeah, in 1918, the SS Macombo ran aground on Lord Howe Island and remained aground for 9 days. During these 9 days, ship rats made their way onto the island, and these rats instantly hit the jackpot. There was so much food with all these phasmids around, and really quickly, these rats became rampant on the island. Only 2 years later, 1920, the Lord Howe Island phasmids were gone and declared extinct, and that was the end of them. Or was it? Well, we'll get back to that. Let's go back to 1964. That failed climbing expedition of Ball's Pyramid did show some promise that maybe some of these insects were living here on this rock, but no living specimens could ever be found. Next year, in February of 1965, Ball's Pyramid was attempted again, this time by a different crew. For this crew, even getting on the island proved very difficult, as the shores are extremely rocky and had large swells and waves. There are also countless sharks that circle this pyramid, so swimming was not advised. Once they got on the island and started climbing, they battled winds constantly, and it took multiple days to try to get up to the top, and required complicated systems to deliver food and supplies to the climbers as they climbed up. They spent their nights climbing up in caves and had to constantly fight against centipedes who would bite them as they slept in those caves. Finally, on February 14th, 1965, the peak was summited. In 1979, another climb to the summit was successful. However, only a couple years later, in 1982, climbing on Ball's Pyramid was banned, and in 1986, visiting the island altogether was banned. This was relaxed a little bit in 1990, and today you need a permit to climb up Ball's Pyramid. A few years later, in 2001, some entomologists were cooking something up. They were familiar with the story of the extinct phasmids on Lord Howe Island and remembered that a few dead ones were found in the 1960s. They devised a plan to possibly find the extinct insect. They would take a boat all the way out here to Ball's Pyramid and climb far up the cliffs and look for frass, which are droppings of the phasmid. They got out here and ended up climbing over 100 meters up this cliff, but didn't see anything on the way up. On their way down, one random bush caught their eye. This bush was almost 100 meters up on a sheer cliff. They had found droppings that looked like they should be from the insect. They looked all around the bush but couldn't actually find any of the insects, as the insects are nocturnal and hid during the day. They came back at night and there they were, the first time in over 80 years that the insect had been found. The researchers found just 24 of them living in a Melaleuca shrub. and these were likely the only ones out there living. The entire insect's fate laid in just this one small bush in this random area on the cliff. If that was destroyed, then the insect would really be gone for good. But how did this Lord Howe Island stick insect even get to Ball's Pyramid, which is pretty far away from Lord Howe Island? In 2017, a genomic study of the specimens were done and showed that the insects here on Ball's Pyramid were actually the same species as the ones in Lord Howe Island. And as I mentioned earlier in the video, fishermen used to use the insect as fish bait. So it's possible that sometime a long time ago, fishermen accidentally released some of the insects here on Ball's Pyramid when fishing. Or maybe birds might have brought them over here from Lord Howe Island. Anyway, fast forward 2 years, in 2003, the Australian government decided that 4 insects could be removed to breed, and researchers traveled back over to Ball's Pyramid to collect 2 males and 2 females. The first of the pairs were sent to a breeder in Sydney, but this did not end well, and they died within a couple weeks. If the other 2 insects died, there was no promise that any would even be left on Ball's Pyramid. This had to go right. The other 2, aptly named Adam and Eve, were sent all the way to Melbourne, to the Melbourne Zoo. Only a few years later, the population was up to 50. By 2008, the population had grown to 700, with over 11,000 eggs, around the time Jane Goodall actually visited the zoo. She was paraphrased as saying the insects sleep at night in pairs, the male with 3 of his legs protectively over the female beside him. Now, this population kept growing and growing, and eggs were sent to zoos all over the world, in Budapest, Bristol, San Diego, Toronto, and recently Prague. Now, these insects couldn't just be re-released onto Lord Howe Island, as those ship rats were still on the island and would simply just eat the insect. In 2017, a decision was made to drop rat poison all over the island to eradicate the invasive ship rat and the house mouse. It wasn't just for the Lord Howe Island stick insect, these rats had driven 5 birds and 3 invertebrates to extinction just on this island alone. The rat poison plan had to be intense, as if only a couple rats made it out alive, then they could easily start breeding and come right back. They based this plan on a similar program in Macquarie Island, which I promise I will eventually do a video on. In 2019, this plan came into place, and they delivered large quantities of rat poison from the sky and the ground. Some locals, yeah, around 300 people actually live on this Lord Howe Island, were rightfully concerned about a lot of rat poison being dropped near their homes, but the plan went through anyway. This quickly destroyed the rat population, and just a few were left hiding on the island. In 2021, a male and a pregnant female rat were found, and 96 more rats were found and eliminated in the next few months. As of 2023, no rats had been seen on Lord Howe Island since then. As of today, plans have been made to bring back the insect to Blackburn Island, which is a small island off the west coast of Lord Howe, to test out the reintroduction program, and hopefully eventually we'll bring the insect back to the main Lord Howe Island in just the next few years. Thanks for watching. Let me know what island I should cover next. Also, check the description for sources and a couple great YouTube videos about the island that go more in depth about some of the topics I talked about in this video.